This is a TEF exclusive where former TOK member, now solo artist Craigie T, talks about his music, the breakup of the group TOK, and statements made by his former group member Flex about Vibes Cartel recording from behind the bars. Now over to our host, the beautiful Samantha.
Boss man, look how the vibes around the sun, make it pop down, make it go round. Big body, little waist, and
jella. She just sticks so broad like an umbrella. The girl act like pepper, she a chicken. A member of the Now Dismantle TOK.
Former member.
Okay.
Yeah.
But it's
former member. Yeah.
It's cool.
TOK. It's cool.
All right. So Craigie, let us just jump into the questions.
Yeah,
right?
Jump in.
everyone wants to know what is the reason for the breakup of the group, because we liked TOK.
Honestly, I think it's just grow, the man them grow apart, you know. Seven men, seven different brothers. You always hear it all the time. Our seven brothers, seven different men. I forget how the saying actually go, but I want to them things. But just know, so one day we did have a discussion, WhatsApp chat, WhatsApp group chat we were in, and we did have a discussion, and then the next day, I hear Flex say he must do his own thing. And which is cool, he never actually said he must leave in TOK, but he said he must do his own thing, and you know, money now fight that. And then after that, me and said basically just say I'm doing one thing too, so it was kind of weird to me.
Okay.
But weird, but at the same time, I wanted them things that never really bothered me because I'm done, I do my one thing already anyway. I feel like the reason for that is that, as I say, you know, every man has their own big man, every king has their own castle, you know what I mean? So I done start building mine already, brick by brick. Everybody who I watch Craigie T over the years would know. So me, I have been stepping out on my own for a little while now.
So basically everyone was doing their own thing yet being a part of the group. So now you guys decide to just...
Some of the feelings, yeah. I'd always felt that way. That's why I kind of thought that it was weird that it became public, so, you know, a man decides to say I'm doing one thing. But then at the same time, it's cool. It doesn't matter, you know.
But what does this mean? To the end of TOK, what does this mean for Craigie T? Do you think that you're doing better as an individual? What does it mean for TOK?
What I can tell you is that I am 100% happier.
Mm-hmm.
I can tell you that my music now is filled with my passion and my passion alone.
Mm-hmm.
And I can tell you that when I'm in the studio, my creative energies are now completely unleashed. You understand? Because at the end of the day, this is me. So when you hear my music, it's my heart and soul in my music. When you hear my lyrics, then you know, say, what me I said is something more real to me.
Mm-hmm.
And because sometimes, you know, you sing a one verse and you hear the song going in a direction, and then you hear another man sing another verse, which is not really the direction you wanted the song.
Mm-hmm.
But the song still sound good and it might still work, but at the same time, it's not completely your energy, so it's not, you know, you don't really feel like you're a baby. No, I'm a song, them are
baby.
Yeah.
I definitely understand. But what is the relationship like? You guys still have a relationship, or?
Alright, what I can say is that the four of us have been together for many, many years.
Mm-hmm.
So them man, they are my brother.
Mm-hmm.
No matter what anybody wants say. No matter what them say, all of them decide to this man, my brother.
Mm-hmm.
As some means there, and some mean up on life. So that's where it is. You know, they're my family. Even though we might not see eye to eye at times. Right now we don't even really talk, to be honest. Like, you know, we don't even really speak. Like, we couldn't even tell when last we have a conversation with either Flex or Alex. Maybe it's a reason every now and then. Boys from last we didn't talk. But we don't really have like that kind of relationship, because we used to see them every day.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And for see a man, for see the same chest that you with them every day for 23 years, a rough something. You see what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
But I just wanted them to think that it was work.
Okay,
yeah.
It was. You guys grew apart. Totally understandable. But Flex made a statement. I don't want to go too much about Flex, but I just want to hear your take on it. So Flex made a very disturbing statement to me about Vibes Cartel. What is your take on that?
Flex is that headed man. We're always in very passionate about some of the things that we feel, and sometimes we talk before we completely think it out. Mm-hmm. That is one side. And then at the other side too, you have to remember, so this is an interview that has been edited too, so you don't really mm-hmm. know mm-hmm. all that was said in that interview. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, yo, flex I'm on man. Mm-hmm. And everybody can on the moon. So anything you say I feel is it's not. So I'm not really pay attention to it. Okay. To be honest. If you don't know what me feel about the whole Vice Cartel situation, you can't tell me. I'm not really busy with what Vice Cartel want or mm-hmm. sing either. Mm-hmm. Because it's Vice Cartel. Mm-hmm. It's
not. Okay, I definitely understand. And you don't think it would actually like taint your reputation? You don't think people would still associate you with T.O.K. Because when people say Credit T, they say T.O.K. When people say Flex or Alex, we think about T.O.K.
Well, the direction I'm on now is trying to build a Credit T brand. Mm-hmm. I think the T.O.K. brand has already been built over the years. So mm-hmm. T.O.K. business is T.O.K. business. I don't deal with T.O.K. business anymore. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, it is my past. Mm-hmm. And it is not something that I'm ashamed of. I've been tattooed the same way. I'm going to wear forever. Mm-hmm. You understand? Mm-hmm. You know, T.O.K. is a part of my history. It will forever be that way. But at the same time, I represent Trinity and I represent Gap Jam.
Mm-hmm. Alright, no problem. But enough about
Flex.
I don't want to.
Are you talking about the
other
about
I'm just going to end this about Flex right
cool,
there.
No problem.
Enough about Flex. Tell me about Credit T. What do you have in store? What's in the pipeline?
Alright, well, recently I shot a video for a single that I have. The girl named Noita Red is called Wham. Bada yard. Mm-hmm. And so the girl them what bada road, but when them go home them nah boy would not be honest. I don't think you would know anything about that.
I don't think you have that. So
that song is out right now. It's a get crazy play on the radio and in the streets them too. I'm mm-hmm. going to Boom Sundays last week. I'm hearing the song I beat out on the girl them going out way happy feet. Mm-hmm. You don't know yourself from a long time.
Happy
she dangerous in energy. And Barbie and all of the girls. Yeah, them love it. Mm-hmm. So we just shot a video for that, so look out for that video soon to be released. I just released a single called One More Song. It's a collaboration with myself and Taurus Riley. Mm-hmm. It was produced by me, it was written by both myself and Taurus. Mm-hmm. It was my bridging from a good little while now, so you know the thing kind of just come out organically. It's a wicked song, nice feel good song. We're not gonna hear it at the end of that interview. We have to have the thing go on. You see what I said? But yeah, so that's that. Look out for the next Gap Jam Records produced rhythm. That's Juggling, set to come out in February 2017. Look out also for the Kenny Smith EP, that's the artist assigned to me, that had the Red Basket. Bad singer, anybody from Sentences is a bit must know Kenny Smith, because I'm a lot of for a long time. Mm-hmm. He's an artist that I manage and produce as well, so look out for that. Yeah, it's an EP that we did in collaboration with a producer called German, who worked out at Big Ship Records. So big up to the whole Big Ship family and crew, you don't know. Chain or Steve and the whole of them OCG, you don't know the large, and of course the captain himself ready. Mm-hmm. Big up enough respect. Check out the YouTube channel, that's a Craigie T YouTube channel, only for things here too. Because we're into fitness as well.
Okay.
So and we're into nutrition as well.
Because you actually
so,
look fit.
I know you're doing it. I tell you, we might have to turn off the camera right now. At least we might have to turn it on, but just go private.
Okay. So you're versatile, but I want to know, because you spoke about a dancing song, you spoke about working with Taurus. I want to know, is this Craigie T a reggae artist or is he a dancehall artist?
I think that the age of genre is soon to be over. Mm-hmm. I think that, you know, that is a question of the past. I think people soon stop asking what kind of genre your music, you know. I mm-hmm. think music is fusing all over, you know, everything. You have Afrobeat / dancehall, you have mm-hmm. you have tropical house, which is really dancehall with a little R&B feel. You have all kind of music coming out now, but it's really just, it's like a hodgepodge, a whole heap of different genres. Mm-hmm. So it sooner or later it's going to become just one music. The music going to just be music. So Craigie T is an artist. So I will fuse my music with everything. But me a Jamaican, me a yard man, of course. Mm-hmm. If you notice in my interviews, yeah, I will speak standard English, but at the same time, you know, I'm gonna shy away from talking patois in on any platform, in a clear where.
Yeah. I see a lot of versatility coming out, and I must commend you for that, which is admired.
Thank you.
But what is your advice for young artists? What would you advise them, which route would you advise them to take coming up in this music industry?
Route. you can't watch, you can't have that, because every, you don't know which route are gonna make you win in other business. Yeah. So you have to just be true to yourself at the end of the day. No, as a matter of fact, I would advise you don't follow no route. Be yourself. You understand? Be yourself at all costs and at all times, unapologetically. You understand? Don't watch your face. Just do you, and eventually people come around. If they're not there at first, eventually they may come around. That would be my advice. And don't make nobody tell you, say, it can't, what you do, nah, go work. Believe in it and push, and you will get it.
Okay, advice. I hope you guys say that advice. But okay, credit team, I want you to tell us more though, because I'm interested.
So
I want to know more.
Trying to say another time, Anika? I know.
But I want to know more.
You don't want to see me again.
I'm going to see you again.
All right.
But I want to know more about Gap Jam. Mm-hmm. I want to know more about that.
Well,
this is solely your label.
Yeah, that's mine alone. Mm-hmm. Mine alone. My friend passed away, and it was a real close bridge of mine. Some of you might know him, passed away a couple of years ago, named Nico Joe. And we were, the whole of we did a vibe, where there was a Naya Bingy launch, basically put out a rhythm called Naya Bingy, and we had a launch out by Wiki Waki one night.
Mm-hmm.
All of we left there about 4 o'clock in the morning. When we reach home 6 o'clock, we get a call from Mr. Little Joe. Asking me if Little Joe dead. And I said, no, that's impossible. I just leave it.
Mm-hmm.
And him, I said, no, then he said, dead. Same time, turn around, but I'm driving straight up by you. And we reach you, he had already passed. And I made a decision right then and there that at the end of the day, my ideals and my thoughts were not going to be kept sleeping.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted people to understand who I was, because I never know when I can pass.
Mm-hmm.
And I never want to pass, and you hear, say, boy, you know, sir, a quarter of that idea is his, because it's a four-man group.
Mm-hmm.
I want people to understand where me I come from completely.
You're
so me start straight, so me start write a whole heap of music at the time, and it was at that time when we just write enough. And like them, I said, boy, we reach a point where I'll have a big meeting, and man, I said, boy, some of the sound that you're right is not your okay music, it's really crazy music, and whatever. And I said, all right, and I was glad that I just do some crazy
mm-hmm,
music.
Mm-hmm.
So I said, all right, man, I'm going to put out no whole for crazy music, but all right, mm-hmm. Let me need that out. Mm-hmm. So I formed the label, I started doing a lot of stuff, I started, you know, the first project, I should tell you, my first project was a song called, I suppose it was in 2010. It was with, I call it Voices of Jamaica.
Mm-hmm.
It was at a time where Cartel would get incarcerated, and Busy Signal would get incarcerated, mm-hmm. and Bojo and a whole heap of people was in trouble with the law. And I wanted to show the rest of the world that dancehall music was still alive, and it had so much more to offer,
mm-hmm.
other than what they were seeing. You understand? Mm-hmm. Than, because you have a way where you have some news channel and they like paint a bad picture. They're not gonna say, yo, I'm gonna get free,
the
man,
energy.
You know what I mean? They're not gonna say that. They're just gonna make it look like, oh my god, murder music from Tio, from the world, from dancehall music, or murder music from Jamaica, or murder music from whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So me, the one say, alright, let the positive make a positive. Mm-hmm. Word. So we did a song called Lean On Me. It was myself, it was T.O.K., Loss, Christopher Martin, D, Major, Taurus Riley at the time. Yeah, man, it was a holy pop song. It was song like a We Are The World kind of thing. That was my first production from ever since my mom statement. I'm more sure so me the music that is going to be around forever.
Mm-hmm.
So that was my first thing, and then after that I met Kenny. In 2013, now I met Kenny while I was judging Rising Stars. I met Kenny Smith. I mean, I said, yo, the youth here, the youth are too talented for just after the show done, I just turn my back and walk out. Like, really and truly, like, me feel like my power, what me have in the business, never work, not if me can't use it, fail up another youth come. So I just decided to produce some more. I check up a producer with him, and I say, you know, producer, I really like make the investment with young artists more time. But you're not sure if you ever see the returns. I understand that completely, because he's a businessman as well. But at the same time, he's a businessman who work off of my gut, I'm a belief. I'm gonna say, yo, die with ya, must boss. So I'm busting. So I just busting. I have a couple of new artists coming out on my next production. I did a song with Shensia. Which is Romy, yeah, man.
Mm-hmm.
A bad artist.
She is.
All right. when I put out my last job, the first person I contact, well, not the first, but the first person I contact outside of my circle was Dario. Because he's a young artist for me to see from a long time, and I say, yo, Dario, you're bad. And I hold it for people now notice. So I said, no, I have to record him too. And it turned out very well. He did a song called FWB, and it was really good. Nice, nice hit. That mash up whole Latin American thing. It's a nice hit. Somebody asked me why I decided to start a record label. I'm telling them, I'm not start a record label. What I'm building is a gateway.
Mm-hmm.
What I'm building is an avenue for young, talented people mm-hmm. can travel and get to the next level. And that may be, may not be a label to just make some money out of some people.
Mm-hmm.
It may open the door for people.
Mm-hmm. Introducing the younger persons who doesn't have an avenue.
For sure.
Mm-hmm.
For sure.
But
sure,
that is commendable.
Give thanks.
And I most respect you for that.
Give thanks. You almost, but I'm glad you did.
So it was nice having you. It was nice. It was a really good talk, and I'm sure I've learned a lot, and I'm sure that the viewers will learn from this interview. So have yourself a wonderful evening.
Thank you.
And
I know all I want to have on myself a wonderful evening too. I make sure to check out the social media pages them. You understand? It's Craigie_TOK. As I said, TOK is my history, but now I left it out. So Craigie_TOK. Craigie_TOK. That's Instagram, that's Snapchat, that's Twitter. Alright? And then so Facebook is facebook.com/theofficialCraigieT. YouTube is Craigie T, there's Craigie TV as well, there's SoundCloud, Craigie T, that just search for Craigie T. Google.
So that's it, guys. Craigie T all over social media. So just Craigie T.
Let me give you that too. Number one shot alone kill man. Everybody cut through the situation. Left one man stand up with the murder weapon. Front of one eyewitness in never bed fan. One nine that alert Babylon. One more covert operation. And in a 1 month kingfish drop like a bomb. One more black incarceration. One extra key can be a drug done. One extra vote can win election. One loose cannon start World War One. And one loose girl cause he hates to kill man. One man we kill another man fear grand. Why would I do them if I 1 million? One good sniff we cause addiction. But one good split release the tension. And just one Craigie T.
That was
like a umbrella. Watch out, me get that one, you may have to chat clever. Me go so I near a low.